Hello there.
Hi.
Whatever is said, just hear the accent and then pick it. There's a rodent in the hood.
I pick the rat.
I pick the rat. I pick the rat if you could.
Yes, everybody. It's time for Pick the Rat. Yeah. It's the public versus us three. This is where we've got a band together. What we want is we're going to pick two Australian listeners. They're going to call in 131060 with regular Australian accents. And then we need one London listener with a regular British accent also in the mix.
Yeah.
They'll all have to say one phrase.
Mate, I don't know whose bum nugget that is. Well, I mean, you introduced us to that phrase. One British person who's doing an Aussie accent is the rat.
And we got a spot.
We have to. We have to.
This is terrible.
We have to pick the rat. Yeah.
What do they? What do we win?
I'm really glad you asked, Ando.
If the rat is successful, meaning we do not pick the British person putting on an accent,
that's a victory for rats.
For rats, and they will all win cheese.
All three callers win cheese.
Right.
If we are successful...
So we are sending via airmail today cheese to Australia.
That's all right. It's already... It's been around for... We'll send it in a rind or whatever. It's not going to go off.
If the rat wins, we do. But if our three minds, beautiful minds combined, can pick out which Londoner is trying to put on an Australian accent, it's a victory for humans and we'll send all three competitors mousetraps.
Because a victory for humans is a loss for rats. So we put three more mousetraps into circulation.
Oh my God, phones have lit up.
Phones have gone crazy.
Richard's up first.
Go for it, Richard. You're only allowed to say the phrase. We will not say anything else to you.
Mate, I don't know whose bum nugget that is.
Thank you, Richard. Okay. That could have been a rat.
Let's have a listen to Steph.
Mate, I don't know whose bum nugget that is.
She's rat-free. That's Australian.
You're
that's
sure?
as an Australian as a
she,
as a
no no
as
no,
an
no.
Australian.
She's
as a that's a koala wearing a cork hat. We're not being hustled by Steph
with corrugated iron blundstones. All right. Let's have a listen to James.
Mate, I don't know whose bum nugget that is.
That's bloody Australian, Andy.
Yeah, I reckon that's
I think
real.
That was Craig McLaughlin. Or check 1-2.
All right.
Oh, which is coming up soon, Shock the McLaughlin. Another contest we can play here on the show. Look, I am tentatively drawing a piece of cheese next to Richard, our first caller.
How are you feeling over there, Christian?
I think it's Steph.
You really think Steph?
Yeah, I think it's Steph.
Lady Rat. It'd be our first Lady Rat.
Yeah, a sexy rat.
Well, no one mentioned she was sexy.
Oh, okay.
I mean, because you know 50% of rats are women, and I'm worried if you find them sexy.
I'm leaning towards Steph as well.
Are you really? Yeah, well, if it's 2-1, guys, bearing in mind, lot rides on this. If we get it right, three mouse traps go out into the population and more rats will die.
Yeah.
If we get it wrong, we have to reward them all with cheese. Now, that's why I'm urging you not to take this lightly.
Do you know what? I'm going back to Richard.
Oh,
wow! Yes.
This is why the game is amazing!
Well, no, it's not amazing. This is the stinkiest thing I've ever done on the radio. It's terrible.
Cheese. Do you want to come across to Steph now, Ham?
I'm holding firm on Richard.
No, I think it's Richard. Yeah.
Okay, Richard, are you the rat?
I'm from Liverpool, I'm the rat.
Richard, you have won yourself a mousetrap. Steph James,
get
you're getting
in.
The same.
Everyone, it's a victory for humans and a loss for rats. Three mousetraps will roll off the production line at 9:01 UK time as soon as the mousetrap factory opens.